feel?
Oh, I had a good time. Thanks for having me. Thanks for being so welcoming to the entire studio. Before I go, I want to thank everyone online and here in our host for being part of the Y community.
Wait, what? What was that dream about?
Was Kevin Olly Kevin? Where is Olly? Oh, he must be eating. Oh, for sure. I will look for him. Yeah. No, you can't believe it. I had this weird dream that you were you flight to Australia again because something happened. And then suddenly I was in the studio with Kevin and your friends from Australia. And I mean, it was amazing, but it was weird having him there.
Martha, it wasn't a dream. I wasn't here yesterday at World Council Daily. But today I am, the last day, and I'm so excited to do it with you.
So tonight, we're going to have our World Council Daily. You can't miss it. We're going to have a lot of fun, right?
Oh, Martha, so much fun. Can't believe that today's day 5 of the World Council 2022. Yay. Our last World Council Daily together. But Martha, got some exciting guests and segments on our show tonight.
Yes, we're going to have a wrap-up, session for the week. And we're going to see some people that we haven't seen yet. So it's going to be super fun.
And Martha, the closing ceremony.
No, it'll be super fun. You have to be there.
I know. It feels like just a minute ago we got here, put our bags down. Now it's all wrapping up. Can't wait to do it tonight, Martha.
Yeah, I can't wait either.
Hello and welcome back to World Council Daily. Martha and Olly bring you all the news from World Council 2022.
I know, we're so excited. Olly, come on. It was amazing how, we see each other again. Yeah. And we were, yes, because I was dreaming so bad. happened?
Martha, it is good to be back. And we've got a big show tonight.
I know, we're going to have a lot of things here. We are going to have a lot of interview, interview today. So we are so excited.
I know, a big show followed by the closing ceremony. But let's throw now to a video of the Four Pillars strategy from today to give us the flavor for tonight's episode.
I'm Mags Gana from Makati YMCA in the Philippines. I am the program secretary and the one in charge in the programs. I'm a staff in the YMCA. And we do a lot of work in youth development in our community. And I also took part in the planning team of the Youth-Led Solutions, which is a project that was launched by the World YMCA to support youth-led programs through funding, mentoring, and these projects had been implemented globally in different parts of the world.
That's great. That's so cool to see that global impact. So do you want to talk a little bit about the collab that you were a part of this week and kind of what your general takeaways have been from that process?
I happened to join the Sustainable Planet group, the collab on Sustainable Planet. And for 3 days, we have a lot of things to talk about this pillar. And on the process, I find it very collaborative and also inclusive, because we were divided into different groups where everybody gets the chance to speak and to be heard. And it was fun to get to know and interact with other people from other YMCAs and to also be listening to their stories, what they're doing to reduce their carbon emission. And what I love about it is the guided process helped us to narrow down our thoughts, because there are so many ideas coming in, but the process helps us to narrow down our thoughts and be able to come up with solutions and ideas which we will pass on to the world committee.
What are kind of some of those solutions that you guys came up with in your collab?
One of the remarkable solutions that came out with the discussion is having a green book or a guidebook for Sustainable Planet for the YMCAs to, to guide them how to measure their carbon footprint, how to conduct programs which are environmentally conscious, how to promote low carbon society and lifestyle and this stuff. So it's that's one of coming up with a green book, which would be useful for both the local, national, and regional YMCAs to be able to help them on how to implement their programs. And, you know, there are simple ways to be included in that book, like using reusable water bottles, and avoid using of plastics, those stuff. Another solution that is also great, that I find it very interesting, is having a platform, an online platform where we could interact with different programs and also provide opportunities for youth-led solution projects to be funded or to have open collaborative network, collaboration work with other local YMCAs in other parts of the world.
It's so cool that you guys were able to have such an incredible discussion around that very important topic in the world and come up with some solutions on how to hopefully create a more sustainable planet, which is so important. And thank you so much for your time today, Max. It was great talking to you, and I hope you have a great rest of your World Council.
Thank you, Mitchell.
Thank you so
Thanks
much.
For having me.
We would love to hear more about what our four pillars will work like, you know, in the after the World Council. So we have someone here, right?
Yeah, we do. We're lucky to have Secretary General of the Global Y. Carlos, thank you so much for joining us. It's probably been a very big week for you. Firstly, how are you?
I'm fine if you're fine.
We're both more than fine. I mean, okay. I guess the week's wrapping up, so sad, but good. Hey, Carlos, maybe you could just tell us, what has this week meant for you?
For me, it's a very important step, but it's just a step, because it's like a new door open to something bigger that is coming. And a few years ago, we know we are going through a process. It was not clear what it is. Now it's clearer, but we know that there's another possibility. So I'm excited. I'm excited about that, and I'm looking forward
to it. Yeah, we're excited also, Carlos. Like, I have to be honest with you, like, this is, for me, is really amazing. How can we all, as the YMCA, can just look, you know, to through the same lens, to the future. So right now we want to ask you, like, what is the message you give to the YMCAs, you know, to motivate them to actually put into practice the Vision 2030 in their plans?
So I will say that the World YMCA, we do not implement. Local YMCA, national YMCA implement. But I see four ingredients in terms of how we implement Vision 2030. is the vision itself is to keep that fire burning, to for people to understand, to remain motivated. It's about the network, for people to realize that we are part of the network and leverage each other's asset. Mm-hmm. It's about the capabilities, the know-how. Mm. So there are many ideas that are here through the collab that are addressing all those. Mm. And the fourth one is about the resources. We need resources to implement all those. Mm. For me, all national movement, local and national movement, we should be clear about our distinctive role. For the World YMCA, our immediate role is to keep the fire burning,
yeah,
to make sure that people feel they are on board and they continue to do so.
Carlos, just on that, so you come to, you know, World Council 2022, whether it's online or in person, and you see how diverse the Y is globally. Mm. When you think about Vision 2030, how do you get that vision through all of the diverse parts of the YMCA, so big, so different?
No, there is the power of the moment where everybody is excited. When there is a good news, it spread like a fire. And I think from this World Council is going to spread.
Yeah.
Everybody is going to go back and talk about it to the local community, local YMCA, national. Yeah. And we need to continue to spread the good news. Mm. So our role is to make sure that, okay, what people are hearing is the good things, and we continue to give the good message. Mm. And the sooner we will be able to share the quick win, the better.
Yeah.
Because with those wins, other YMCA will get more inspiration to continue the journey.
That's totally true. Actually, I have to tell you, like in Latin America, we're so excited to do it. So I believe that fire that you're just talking about, it will be like spread out for sure.
Yes.
Carlos, thank you so much for joining us. But more than just joining us, thank you for your contribution to the YMCA in the world. You walk around this place and it's like you're a celebrity. I can see why, because you're so generous and graceful with your time. So thank you for joining us. And now we'll throw to a little clip of behind the scenes.
We just passed our strategy, Vision 2030, which is our wish to contribute to the sustainable development goal. That's why it's Vision 2030.
So it's amazing to have you here, and I truly admire your job. Just amazing.
Well, yeah. Well, Kerry, I just met you and I also admire you.
That social media is but a blip on life. If we choose to make that blip our world, we're gonna miss out on life. We can choose to use social media to communicate, but it's just a tool, nothing more. It's not life.
YMCA has been there since day one. And when I say this, I do not just mean the full-scale war that started in February. I was actually at World Council in Estes Park in the US back in 2014 when the war in Ukraine started 8 years ago. And I wasn't even sure if I would be able to go back at that time. So now, 8 years after this, here I am again at World Council, and we have the full-scale war in Ukraine, and I'm wondering what's happening next. Where are we in 4 years at the next World Council?
Hi everyone. So there are so many people that are behind the scenes making World Council Online happen and putting together content to keep all of you guys informed on what's been going on here in Denmark. One of those people is Sophia here. You have been putting together content on all the different collabs and panels. What is that process like before you even show up? How are you prepping these pieces for these events?
Yeah, so obviously there's always a lot of research that goes into it. You have to look into the panelists, into the actual themes, subjects that are going to be discussed. So there's a lot of pre-writing, and then a lot of note-taking during the panel, obviously, or during the collabs. It was really fun because I was even able to join some of the group discussions during the collabs. A lot of people really inviting and actually allowing me to speak within their group. So that was really enriching for me and for what I'm actually going to be writing. And yeah, now I have a lot of writing to do, a lot of web stories to write. I'm very inspired by everybody. I've heard very inspiring things. Everybody seems just so hopeful and ambitious and optimistic about what the YMCA can do and its potential.
Well, thank you for everything you've done this week, Sophia. You're a rock star. Thank you. In person at World Council, there are so many people like Candace here who are making the experience so much better and smoother for all those attending here in Denmark. So Candace, where are you from? Tell us a little about what you do here at World Council.
So I'm from Switzerland, and I am a volunteer who's normally in charge of registration. So on the two first arrival days, I help people register, get their badges, tell them a bit how it works, where to go, and also give them a goodie bag, which is very important at the YMCA. And once registration is over, we're always here to help, especially find collab numbers, dinner with a Dane to help sure they get all the information they need. And now that it's ending, make sure they get the right bus times of how to get to the airport, and just try and make be as helpful as possible.
Truly a superhero here at World Council. So, like, what has that experience been like for you? Like, how has it been managing coordinating all of that?
I mean, I love it. It's super fun. It's a bit stressful the first few days when registration opens and you have 1,000 participants queuing in front of you. But it's super easy, especially this time we had a new system where we print the badges on site, which has made it super easy for us compared to the old way where it was digging through boxes for the badges.
That's no fun.
So, yeah, no, it's really fun.
Well, thank you so much for everything you do for making World Council a reality. Thank you.
I love it. No problem.
Lastly, shows like this and the upcoming closing ceremony that you guys are about to see, a lot goes into it on the production side of things, and people like Makita here are helping put that all together and make it accessible to you all. So Makita, tell us a little bit about who you are and what you do here at the World Council.
So I work for the World Alliance, and my job here is to make sure that everything happens as close to the plan as possible, because we know that it may not be 100% there. So we work a lot with the interpretation platform. We make sure that it works, and I hope it works. We check. We seems like we're getting there. We work a lot on the C-Ven platform. We make sure that correct lists of people are assigned to correct sessions, so you see relevant for you content. We are helping also the Danish host team in order for their operations to run smooth. So, yeah. To be fair, my favorite part is the backstage, probably. And the people are very, very, very amazing. The production team, the Get Visual team, amazing, everyone. So people is everything.
Well, awesome. Thank you so much, Makita, for everything you do. It's a reality. Hopefully everything goes well tonight for the closing ceremony. And we'll go back to you guys.
We are joined by great chair of the Danish Hof team. And she's actually from here. So great. Welcome. How are you today?
I'm feeling very, very relaxed today, because now the World Council is so well done, I think, and people has met so many new people. And we are just very satisfied about being the host city of this World Council.
And you shall be.
Congratulations on putting on the most wonderful World Council in person and for the online delegates as well. You're from Aarhus, and we're in your home. What does it mean to have everyone from the Global Y here?
Well, I would say it's quite a big moment, because many times I have been traveling out of Denmark to meet the YMCA world. And now suddenly we have so many people from all over the world in this town. And it's just like a dream coming through, I think.
Absolutely. How this process of like putting everything together have been for you? Like, can you tell us a little bit about it?
Well, you can say that, of course, there has been a lot of work to do, but we also, I think what was quite important for the Danish movement was that we had a quite clear idea of what we wanted with the YMCA World Council in Denmark. So we wanted to take the world into Denmark and giving it out to our local YMCAs, but also trying to introduce the global perspective and the mindset to our global YMCA, our local YMCAs, and at the same time giving something back to the world, because we have been so inspired by the world to so many years.
Grit, in terms of the process of putting this together, I imagine it's a long process, it's a complicated process. What's been, in your mind, the biggest challenge and the biggest success?
I think the biggest challenge was the COVID coming in, and it was a game changer, and it wasn't until February this year that we finally decided that the World Council would go on in a physical edition in Aarhus. And that was such a relief to us that it would actually be here in the music house, because we were so excited about that. So that has definitely been the biggest challenge. The biggest success, I think, is having this sense that people has connected with so many new people, with the dinner with the Danes, seeing people in the old city, just hanging around and chatting and having their meals and even singing in the rain. That was just very nice.
Yes, and I have to be honest with you, like, it is my first World Council and it's been amazing. So thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for all your work. It's been, unforgettable.
It has. Yeah.
And thank you for coming.
Oh, thanks for having us. And thank you for delivering such a world conference. Wonderful World Council, as Malfe said. And thanks for joining us, Grit.
You're welcome.
Welcome back to World Council Daily. And Martha, how cool is it to meet people from all over the world?
I know. I met like a lot of people, like new people. Yeah.
Well, we're so lucky to have in the studio with us today, Peter Dinsdale, the CEO of the Y in Canada. Peter, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
How are you, firstly?
I'm doing great. I'm a bit tired at the end of the week, but you know, we're in the home stretch, so looking forward to the closing ceremonies tonight.
Tell us about your week.
Well, we flew in at the weekend. All my flights were fine, by the way. Got all my bags on time. And I really found this World Council to be fantastic. I was in Chiang Mai last time and got to experience that process. And I see how we grew here. Of course, getting to pass the next strategic plan, Vision 2030, was very special. But I think equally special is meeting with all our international colleagues and friends and meeting more people. It really makes us feel connected as a global movement.
Mm. Can you tell us a little bit what the Vision 2030 will mean for you at your YMCA?
Yeah, well, I mean, we have our own strategic plans, obviously, but it's great to make sure that we're linking together and working together have greater impact than just what we can alone. So it gives us some guideposts on how to align our efforts locally to make sure that we're really influencing at the international level. I also think areas like climate change and just world helps us, helps youth in our communities, and help us all kind of elevate our game to be global citizens. So it's a wonderful opportunity.
Amazing.
You know, I think in some respects it's been a weird time with the pandemic, and we've often been looking quite inwards. What does it mean for the YMCA in Canada to be out here in a global arena again?
Well, you know, generally I think if we do our jobs well, we're not just looking internally at having the best communities and facilities we have, we're also about having the greatest impact that we can have in our communities. And you elevate that internationally, what's the best impact that we can have in the world? What's the force for good that we can be? And again, we see the Just World resolutions and or pillars and resolutions, and you think about our work in climate change. It really gives you that bigger ambition that the work we're having every day locally, cumulatively, has this greater impact internationally.
That's terrific.
As we say, we're local, right? So the local goes just global.
Speaking of global, I guess, we're also thrilled to be joined by Hannah online. Hannah, how are you?
I'm great. Thank you for having me.
Hannah, where are you joining us from? And tell us about your week.
Awesome. Yeah, so I'm in New Brunswick, Canada, so I'm on the east coast of the country. I think this experience has been wonderful. I think it's this hybrid event has provided such a great opportunity for folks like myself who can't be there in person to still be involved and have incredible conversations with folks from all across the world.
So can you take us, tell us a little bit about your takeaways of the week, like those highlights?
Yeah, I think some of my highlights have honestly just been the incredible conversations that have been able to take place. I took part in the Just World Collabs, and so we had a lot of conversations about diversity and equity and inclusion, and what does that look like, and how do we put that into practice, and also the elevation of youth voices. I'm sure Peter can tell you, I met him at the Y Canada conference a few weeks back, and elevation of youth voices is something that I take a lot of pride in, and then a very personally driven to work towards. And so I'm excited to take some of the things we've heard about here at World Council and bring them back to the Ys in Canada and our local Y.
Hannah, thank you so much for your time, for sharing that. It's just terrific to have a World Council that's both, you know, integrated for the online delegates and also for the ones in person. Peter, thank you for joining us and sharing your perspective of YMCA Canada. We're really grateful for your time, and safe flight home.
Thank you so much.
Gracias.
Hello, my name is Laura Starezi. I'm from YMCA East Jerusalem, Palestine. I'm thrilled to be here in the World Council.
Hi, I'm Sarah from the Danish YMCA, and I hope everybody online is enjoying the World Council as much as we are here.
And I'm Leah, nice to meet you all.
Oh, I'm so tired. Like, this whole week has been so much fun, but I'm tired. Like, I feel that this is so many things going on. I did a lot of things. So I think I'm going to find friends from here to explain me a little bit more about the hygge thing, because I know that will be amazing for me. Guys, do you want to join me? Hey!
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Sune, I'm from Denmark.
And I'm Matthias, and I'm also from Denmark.
That's amazing. So guys, can you explain to me a little more about the hygge? I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right.
You aren't, but it's fine. Of course we can. We love to hygge us. It's just, you know the feeling when you're with your friends and you're just so comfortable. You're really living in the moment. You're just enjoying it. You don't care about the phone. You're just enjoying the moment. What about you, Matthias?
For me, hygge is something you both do and something you also feel. For me, one moment I really hygge meg is when I drink coffee with my friends and it's just calm and relaxing.
Well, we brought something along to show how we hygge us.
Oh, it's Legos. Yeah. I love Lego! Yes! Guys, this is so much fun. Thank you for this. But you know what? I think I like better the idea that you had before, like, you know, like having coffee and have a good chat. How does it sound?
Perfect. Let's go grab a cup of coffee. Isn't this life?
Oh, it's amazing. Now I think I am feeling the hygge. Yeah,
it's good to hear.
Thank you guys for helping me find my hygge.
Just take it home with you.
Of course I will take it. Olly, it was amazing to find my own sense of hygge. And you know what? I invited my friends Matthias and
Soon.
Yeah, sorry. And soon. They are going to tell us a little bit more about the hygge.
The hygge. Now, first, Matthias, soon. Are we saying that word properly?
No.
Okay.
Definitely not.
Okay, so how do you say it?
Hygge.
Muffet, do you want another go?
Hygge.
I don't think that was right.
No.
It wasn't.
Matthias, perhaps we'll start with you. What does hygge mean to you?
Well, for me, it's kind of a way to like have a cozy and relaxing time with friends and family. Like, it can mean a lot of different things. Mm. It could be you having a cup of coffee with your friends or just watching a movie.
Okay. Sun, what do you
think? For me, it's enjoying the small moments.
Yes.
And obviously, you got to have your friends and family there.
Yeah.
But enjoying the small moments, it's the small moments that make your life happy and make you happy and keeps you happy.
Yeah.
So yeah, for me, it's just small moments.
I have to say, Mafia, I love this concept.
I
that really special feeling that for me, you feel a lot at the YMCA where you're happy, you're contented, you're with people you love, you feel a sense of direction. Is that hygge, Sun?
I think so.
Yeah.
I think so, yeah.
Mm. Yeah, and also the meaningful conversations, you know, it's just, I think that's hygge, but I don't know. What do you think, what are the benefits of hygge?
Mm. Well, it keeps life kind of casual and you don't take life so seriously when you're just relaxing all the time.
Yeah.
And just keeps you happy, like I said, yeah.
Because, Matthias, it's not just a feeling as well, like it can be like lighting, can't it? It can be a sense of like mood or vibe. How does it work in that regard?
Well, I think it can be all of those things. Like, it can be something you do.
Yeah.
It can also just be how you feel.
Well, so Matthias, can I ask?
Yeah.
When you think of hygge, what do you think of?
Well, I think of something like having a good cup of coffee with my with my family or playing a board game.
Nice. It's beautiful.
So how do you think we can take hygge home?
Yeah, well, it's kind of hard. First, you need a word for it. And you can't steal ours. It's way too hard to pronounce.
Well, we can't steal your words in because we can't say it properly. But we might try to steal the concept, I think.
Yeah, of course.
I think we should, because why not? It's a good concept. We think so. It's ours, so of course we think so.
Mm. So, a question, when you think of hygge, what do you think of? What's the first thing that comes to your mind?
Well, it's almost the same with the coffee with your family, but for me it's beer with the friends.
Yeah.
I'm Danish, so I enjoy beer.
I mean, if hygge is essentially the feeling of comfort, of satisfaction, my goodness, Mafe, it's been a lot of hygge this week.
I know, yes, for me, yes, 100%.
Matthias, Sun, thank you so much for joining us, and thank you for your efforts in putting on the most wonderful World Council.
You're welcome.
Muchas gracias.
The game's called Ladder Golf.
And the game is on.
I think this is where I take over. The production team have clearly had some fun with my makeshift costume. So by my calculations, at the moment, we have 4 points. Mafe, you have 2. You could still win with a magic shot. Oh no, we have ourselves a winner. Unfortunately, Mafe, you are not the winner today. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Fair and square.
Hi everyone. As World Council's wrapping up, we've all been reflecting on the lessons learned and the growth we've experienced this past week. Which we spoke to a few people to hear a little bit about some of the growth they've experienced this year at World Council.
Hello, my name is Mario from YMCA Siderno in South Italy. I had a good experience here at the World Council. I was really enjoying the gathering with people, sharing stories with other people, and I had to learn. Like I went through a process of developing new partnership with local to local YMCA, which were really relevant for our local YMCA. And we are under discussion to build new things to make our YMCA growth and to empower more young people in the future.
My name is Esona Kunwana from South Africa. And during this World Council, I've learned I was able not only to grow as an individual, but I've learned about how other YMCAs operate and how sometimes we have similar struggles and on how other YMCAs have overcome those struggles and probably implement the same strategies in my branch at the YMCAs so that we can overcome the struggles and in the diversity that we have. We have different cultures and probably different religions, but then in the YMCA we were even though we even if we do have different religions, we're able to be okay, to bond with those people, and it was such an awesome experience for me.
Hi, my name is Mariana Kelly. I am from the YMCA of Aruba. This week has been very inspirational, encouraging. From the start of the week with Ban Ki-moon's speech, it was very inspiring, and it has really stuck with me about the balance of passion and compassion. So that's something that I really want to bring back home and try to unite the YMCA and the volunteers and the staff and to engage our community more with the YMCA. I actually engage in the sustainable work, and I think it's a great, there are many ideas, and I think there are great opportunities in there to collaborate locally, but also internationally. There are so many ideas out there, and this is just a great moment to meet new people, to get new experiences, their ideas, what are they already doing, and what are the things that I can implement back home. So I really want to pledge that I will help my youth on my island to get better skilled, getting to know themselves first and better skilled at what they can do and what for jobs they will be able to do.
Yeah, so my name's Adam. I'm from YMCA, YWCA Denmark. And I mean, we're part of the host team as well. So I think one of the things that I've definitely learned these couple of days is actually being a bit proud. I mean, we're not that good in Denmark at addressing the things that we're really, really good at. It's maybe something that is underlying everything we do, but when we put it into perspective and we are kind of forced a little bit to talk about it and present it for the rest of the world, I mean, we end up being a little bit proud. And we're just sitting talking before as well, some of the group from Denmark, and we're like, guys, this is actually a great achievement for us. This is amazing. We hosted this entire World Council just carried out by volunteers, and I mean, that's what the Vision 2030 is all about. It's about empowering young people. It's about creating the spaces for young people, as myself, but also the entire Danish delegation, for actually getting all these little great experiences of success, achievement, knowing, okay, I can actually do this, I can do this, and that grows into, I mean, this is just a small World Council, but these experiences and these successes, that's what gives us the opportunity and the empowerment to actually believe, okay, I can make change, I can actually do something about changing the world.
So my name's Caitlin, I'm from Y Ballarat in Australia. And a moment that's really resonated with me this week was during the excursions, we went to a place called Colling, and we went to a community hub there. And just the atmosphere of the community hub and what it is that they were doing there really resonated with me and resonated with some of the work that I'm doing and that my Y is doing back in Ballarat with our youth hubs and the hopes and that we and the things that we want to achieve in our youth hubs and the environment that we want to be able to set for our young people there.
Was there any specific pillars or aspects of Vision 2030 that really have connected with you that you want to bring back home with you?
I think community wellbeing, creating safe spaces for young people in particular within our community, creating spaces for them to feel comfortable and feel safe to have conversations and to say things that they may not feel comfortable saying in other spaces, things that might be a little bit political or things that might be a little bit divisive or things that they just feel uncomfortable talking about in other spaces. I think it's really important for us as the Y to create those spaces for young people to have those conversations and to make those changes.
Awesome, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And welcome back to World Council Daily. Marfair, I can't believe it, but it is the last day of World Council 2022.
I know, I kind of feel like
nostalgic, sorry.
Nostalgic.
Yes. Yes, because it's our last day.
I know.
Come on.
I know. Well, yeah. Muffin, speaking of nostalgia, we are so thrilled to have Ronald joining us online, Isabel joining us in the studio. Thank you both for being here. Ronald, I'm going to start with you. Firstly, can you hear me loud and clear? And how are you?
I'm doing great. I'm wonderful. I'm hearing you loud and clear. I just can't see you at the moment.
Well, you're not I'm missing much, not seeing us, so.
I'm seeing the wonderful people around. Yeah, now I'm seeing you.
Ronald,
how you guys doing?
Ronald, tell us about how today has been for you and how the online World Council is going.
Well, today has been wonderful. I'm looking at the new president coming in and delivering an amazing speech, looking at the transition there from Patricia to Sahela. We had the end note, and it's been amazing going through the collabs, especially in the session I was in Pillar 2 of Meaningful Work. It's been amazing having different delegates from all over the world talking about how it's important for YMCA employees to have meaningful work, to be attractive enough to attract young people to take over the mantle of leadership. So we have a lot of work to put together. Even though we come from different realities, we still are fighting towards one common vision, which is Vision 2030, meaning that in meaningful work, we all have to work together to make sure that all our employees, all our volunteers have the need to be at the YMCA to push this agenda. It's been wonderful, and man, I just don't want it to end.
That's so good. And you know what? I feel your energy from there. So it's amazing. It seems like you were having fun and also that it was really impactful for you. Thank you. Now, Isabella, can you tell us a little bit how the week have been going and also tell us a little bit about you because you are our new guest here. Yeah.
Okay. This week has been truly amazing. Like everything about it. We met so many people from so many different countries. We got the chance to talk a lot about our different realities, you know. Each one of us has their own reality in our local YMCAs, in our local area. And I think it's amazing how we can see that. And it's so shocking for us to realize and be able to bring all that information to see how different we are and how we can change, you know.
Yeah,
that's amazing. So you are from Brazil, right?
Yes, I'm from Brazil.
We're like diverse. Thank you.
Isabel, what's been the biggest takeaway for you this week?
Sorry?
The most important, or what have you got out of this week? The number one thing.
I think it's like the collabs, like they're so, it's different from everything I've ever experienced. We got the chance to talk a lot and to join our ideas into this big project that we can bring to our YMCAs.
That's amazing. And I bet that's what Ronald has lived as well, because I just keep seeing he's smiling and he's doing this with his head because exactly.
I mean, Ronald, number one thing from this week, can you put your finger on it or too difficult to say?
Well, it's too difficult because it's all been amazing. But one thing I've enjoyed the most is part of the daily shows and where we do a recap of everything that's happened throughout the day. But another important thing is the resolutions that have been passed. It's so amazing to see that all of them passed unanimously, and it shows that we are on the right path. And something that came out today, and I was amazed and I was happy that all the resolutions that have been put forward by National YMCA is working towards peace, working towards giving the youth more space to participate in the progression of the YMCAs have all been passed. Now it's left on us, all in our national movements, to make sure that we realize these resolutions and we push towards it, especially working towards 2030. We don't need to reinvent the wheel. Most of the time, like you, Mafe, you're saying that YMCA of Brazil is your neighbor. YMCA of Brazil could have a solution to a problem that you don't need to start working on early. You know, you just take the solution from them and apply it in your country. So basically, we have a lot of work to do. It's 8 years away, but it's 8 years that we can effect change. And today has been an amazing day.
Ronald, so well put. Thank you, Isabel. Thank you very much for joining us. And thanks for all you've been doing to make World Council 2022 absolutely unbelievable.
Welcome to Aarhus, Denmark, our home for World Council 2022. So Muffet, what's the bike doing on stage now? Is this our next guest that we're interviewing?
We are doing it now. Go ahead.
Get on the bike?
Yes, of course. What do you think is this for?
This is one of our first ever segments together.
Yes.
Are you excited to be here with the tandem bike?
Of course. We're going to burn all those calories that we just ate.
Now, look, Muffet, I did eat a lot of calories. Did you watch what I ate before we got on stage?
Yes, I saw.
Muffet, I didn't know we'd be doing this when we flew to Denmark, but I'm so glad that we are.
Yes, me too.
How many United Nations Sustainable Development Goals are there? Ooh. How many UN SDGs are there? This is your last question. We need the winner of the first ever World Council Daily Quizmaster, because she was closest, is Mafe. There are 17 SDGs. Oh, we've lost Olly.
And welcome back to World Council Daily. Mafe, I can't believe it, but we're almost at the end.
Yes, I think I'm gonna cry. It's been an amazing week. It's been so much fun. It was so nice to meet you, Olly.
Mafe, it has been so great hanging out with you all week and dissecting the most wonderful World Council. But Mafe, it couldn't be done without some very important people. First of all, can we give it up for the crew, everybody? Been absolutely unbelievable. And while we're rolling that applause, of course, for our famous producer, Kurgan, round of applause, everyone.
And for all the staff that put all this together, we were so impressed the first time. We didn't know it was going to be like this. But yes, thank you so much for all of you.
You know, Mafe, it might come as a surprise, but we're not professionals. We've had such a good time. But most importantly, what a wonderful World Council. It's been brilliant. We've got to finish up though, because we're about to go to the closing ceremony.
I know, we need to rush.
Yeah, Mafe, thank you. And thank you, everyone. Bye. Thank you so much. And thank you for joining us for World Council 2022.
Gracias.